Today on Upfront, the Republican primary scramble. Will states like Wisconsin be lost in the shuffle?
So the reality is the states that are playing by the rules are going to have even more say over the next presidential nominee from the Republican Party than they do right now.
Then lawmakers back at work for a special session on jobs. Why Democrats say the session is neither special nor job-creating.
And people cannot count on 3 or 4 years from now to have the business climate be better. They want us to do everything we possibly can to advance initiatives to put them back to work quickly.
And the end of Earn a Buck in Wisconsin. It might make hunters happy. Today, why some experts argue it could be a bad move in the long run. It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. It's a little hard to believe, but the first votes in the presidential campaign are a little more than 10 weeks away. The Republican National Committee asked states to set its primaries after March 6, 2012, with exceptions in February for Iowa, New Hampshire, Nevada, and South Carolina. Wisconsin complied, moving its presidential primary back from February to April 3, 2012. But Florida disregarded the RNC rules and moved its primary up to January 31st. That set off a chain reaction of traditionally early states moving up their primaries or caucuses. Five contests are now set between January 3rd and February 4th. Our question today, will Wisconsin, which played by the rules, still matter when it comes to selecting the Republican presidential nominee? We're asking former state party chairman and now chairman of the Republican National Committee, Reince Priebus. Mr. Chairman, thanks for being with us today. So the question is, I know it's difficult to gaze into a crystal ball given what's happening in the presidential contest, but will Wisconsin matter come April?
Yeah, Mike, first of all, great being back. Yeah, I think that Wisconsin is absolutely going to matter. It's going to be a winner-take-all election. All the elections after April 1st can be winner-take-all. It's going to matter because the reality is, yeah, Florida violated the rules, and they're going to suffer some consequences because of it. And early states are going to be conducting their primaries a little bit earlier now. But the reality is, when you look at the percentage of delegates, nothing changed. All that has changed is that those five states are going to conduct their primaries in January instead of February, but that didn't cause any other states to move backwards into February. So in reality, what you have is the same proportion of delegates going instead of in February, going in January. All of those delegates in those states, Mike, are actually going to get cut in half. So the reality is the states that are playing by the rules are going to have even more say over the next presidential nominee from the Republican Party than they do right now.
How about this fall, Chairman Priebus? You have said in the past that you do not believe President Obama can be reelected without winning Wisconsin. You've said that Wisconsin is going to be ground zero in many respects for this race. But I see the president right now focusing a lot of his time on places like Virginia and North Carolina. Is it possible that Wisconsin's role in the presidential outcome will be diminished this time around?
No. Wisconsin will be, it'll be, first of all, it's going to be a battleground state. There's no doubt about it. The national party, the presidential candidates are going to be heavily invested into Wisconsin. The Republican Party there and Republicans, the conservative movement in Wisconsin, they know how to win. It's obvious. The big wave that we had last November, then Prosser coming back and winning again, then the Democrats falling on their face with these Senate recalls again. And if they want to go ahead and try to recall Walker, they're going to fail again, and it's just going to energize the base even more. Wisconsin's in play in a major way, and the reality is that the Republicans are doing very well in that state right now, led by Scott Walker.
I'm sure Democrats watching this would say, well, we actually won a majority of the recall elections. Are they wrong when they say that?
Well, all you have to do is roll the tape, and anything but an absolute flip of the state Senate was a loss to those folks. They didn't flush $30 million down the toilet just to fall short. So if that's what they want to do again, great. That's less money they're going to have for the general election in November, and Scott Walker is going to be even stronger. And I think the reforms are going to continue. And guess what? The people of Wisconsin want these reforms to take place. And it's obvious because the Democrats just haven't been able to put two and two together to accomplish any of their goals.
Let's talk about the presidential race. Some pretty tough talk in that race in recent days. I saw a web video from Governor Perry where he essentially calls Mitt Romney a liar. I mean, that's really what the web video says in the 1 minute. Are you worried this is going too far? There's some in your party who say it's time to tone things down a little bit. This is not good long term for our party. Do you share that concern?
Yeah, no. I mean, I wouldn't take it to that level. I mean, I certainly believe that the candidates are playing pretty well in the sandbox, I would say. And the reality is, this is a primary. You know, primaries aren't always, you know, vanilla and cotton candy. And it certainly wasn't the case when Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama were running against each other. I mean, you mean remember they fought it out all through the end of June before the election. And guess what? Barack Obama won pretty handily, and it worked pretty well for them. It worked well in Wisconsin. I mean, just think back of last year. You had Mark Newman, Scott Walker, you had Terrence Wall, Dick Leinenkugel, Ron Johnson, Dave Westlake. We had a full-blown primary situation in Wisconsin, and it wasn't always pleasant. But guess what? All the horsepower lies with the folks in the big primaries. I believe in big primaries, so... As you know, Mike, I've been saying that for many years, and I think this is just great that the talk is on the Republican side of the aisle. And the reality is Barack Obama's failed miserably. I mean, our economy's in a ditch. He hasn't accomplished a single thing. And guess what? He has a love affair with the sound of his own voice. But what the American people know is that he's not in love with following through on his promises. That will upend him in November, and it'll upend him in Wisconsin, where people just want real leadership there, and they're seeing what real leaders are all about in Scott Walker.
Let me follow up on that. You say he hasn't accomplished anything, but in past campaigns, Republican candidates have gone after Democrats' perceived weakness on national security. Okay, in the last few months, we've seen Osama bin Laden killed, Anwar al-Awlaki killed, Muammar Gaddafi killed. This all happened under President Obama's watch. Does he not get credit for that? Is that issue now off the table for Republicans?
Well, you know, the reality is, you know, first of all, there are accomplishments, I think, through the military and the CIA and the FBI and national security, and to the extent that the president deserves some credit for that, that's fine. And I don't think anybody has said differently. But where I think the voters' minds are, and where the minds of people that are going to that will be going to the polls in Wisconsin are, is in the economy. And Obama's made everything worse. I mean, he's made a couple simple promises. Number one, he's going to put people back to work. We've got 9.1% unemployment. He said he'd cut the deficit in half. Mike, guess what? He introduced the biggest structural deficit in the history of America. He said he'd get the debt under control. What happens? Under his watch, under his policies, he's put our country on track and on a trajectory to accumulate more debt under his presidency than every single president before him combined. I mean, the fact is, however you slice it and dice it, this president has made everything worse and hasn't followed through on his promises. So while I hear what you're saying there, I think the voters are going to be looking at the economy, and there's just no way this president gets a passing grade on that.
The chairman of the Republican National Committee, former chairman of the Wisconsin Republican Party, Reince Priebus, on the satellite from Washington. We appreciate your time today. Thank you.
Hey, go Packers!
Next, state lawmakers go back to work in a special session on jobs. Democratic Assembly Leader Peter Barca's take on the session, and is he seriously consider running against Governor Walker in a recall?
Upfront with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.